Jesus, that thing's got some punch in it.
I hate the trout.
How come those ones stick to the wall?
Can you get me a GoPro?
Yes. No. Pretty epic day on the river yesterday. Long and epic. And fixing a hole in the raft. With this new latex stuff, you put it inside the raft and it bubbles out. We've never used it before, so it's kind of a first. And look who we've got visiting. It is Simon and Sarah from Wild Places, Wild Game. Now, if you haven't looked at their YouTube channel yet, I recommend going over and checking it out, guys, because he's put a lot of work into it. And he is also a hunting guide. So if you guys want to get yourselves onto a pig or a deer, father-son meat hunts, general meat hunts, also trophy stag hunts behind a fence and not behind a fence, he pretty much does it all, tar and chamois. Go see this fella right there. Give him a ring. 021 RD Stag, which stands for Red Stag, not Road Stag. I thought it was Road Stag, but it turns out it's Red Stag. And we don't know what we're doing today. Simon's gone down to Wateroa. And we're going fishing. We're going to go jet boating and fishing. I'm not too sure, we're just trying to figure that out. What are you doing, Charlie? Having Nerf wars?
Yeah.
You going to come fishing? Charlie's on the fence because his mate's over from Christchurch, so he kind of wants to hang out with his mate. This is Adventure Dan. You may remember Dan from such videos as turn a raft upside down and almost kill 5 people. And other such movies. Take two. You may remember Dan from turn a raft upside down and scare the living daylights out of 5 guests. Slight hiccup. I have lost the bung for my jet boat. We come off the river the other night and it's gone. I don't know where it is. It's disappeared. Hopefully someone in town will have a bung. If not, we'll just have to mouldy it up, bro. Let's go burn some gas. Burn some gas. That's a plan for today. Burn some gas, catch some fish. Oh, I completely forgot to get Dan a life jacket, but that's alright, the river is low flow. We're both swift water rescue technicians, we know what we're doing. I don't advise anyone to go jet boating without a life jacket, but today I think we can manage the risks. I think it's a manageable risk, low flow river. If we fall out or whatever, or if Dan knocks himself out, I can just swim and get him and abandon ship. So we'll be fine. Few, mate, minor problems, not majors yet, I don't think. My heads aren't that hot, but the exhaust is bloody hot. The exhaust jacket's sizzling. Hey, look, there's an airplane on the beach. Blimmin' heck, there's always bloody something, eh?
Always something.
And we can't just row down back to the truck. We've got to go up a river to get back to the vehicle, so we're not out of the woods yet.
Maybe catch some kawai later.
Oh yeah, catch some kawai later. We may even go hunting later too, I think. Go shoot a deer, maybe. Or go hunting. Hopefully we'll shoot a deer. We'll see. Figured out what was going on. There was a little tiny stone inside the water system, the water cooling system, that must have blocked it up. I'm assuming that's what went wrong, and then that caused the water to stop flowing. I cooked this exhaust. Look at that. Absolutely cooked it. Which is a bugger, but when I bought the jet boat, it came with this, which has also been slightly cooked. But I'm gonna get some exhaust wrap and wrap this up, and hopefully that'll fix it. Anyway, we're going fishing and hunting now, without the jet boat. Blimmin' heck, we've got down to the river mouth, and the river's really dirty. There must have been a big landslide up the river, or I fall up at the glacier, because it's really silty. The other rivers are running reasonably clear, but this one's still really dirty, so I don't think we're going to catch any kawa, but we'll give it another 40 casts. Might put a trout spinner on, I think, and see if I can fish the tannin water right on the sides. There's sometimes big brown trout sit right up against the sides there.
One strike, that's it.
I caught the bottom a few times and a bloody tourist everywhere. We just seen a dude go by with a roll of dunny paper, two bottles of beer and a bottle of lemonade. Bugger the deer hunting. There's not going to be any deer around here. Anyway, there's just people camping everywhere. A bit dodgy. Sorry about the anticlimax here, guys. Once again, no fish, no deer. We figure we'll go back to that clearing after it rains because we were just in there recently and it hasn't rained yet. So hunt smarter, not harder. We probably just would have gone and sat there till it got dark, eaten by mosquitoes and then come home. So you get to watch us have a nice cup of tea now. How awesome is that? Next day, we're down at the lake, and I put another exhaust sleeve on it and wrapped it, put my otter on, silicone the hole shut, wrapped it with tape, and I got some silicone tape in the mail, but hopefully it'll go. I don't know if I've cooked the engine on it. I don't think so. It should be all right. I flushed the cooling system out, and yeah, there was a few stones in there. So we'll see if it's gonna work. It's not looking good. These couple of lads here, the local mechanics, and they tell me it's probably a head gasket. Is when I take the filter off, it's warm, there's warm water in there. That means it's blowing warm water back down the cooling system, and there's also gas fumes in the other end of the cooling system. So pretty sure she's blowing heat gasket, and that's why the cooling isn't going through, because it's just getting blown down the tubes. Bugger. It's another day, and we're just about to go rafting and hunting with Smiddy and the lads. And I was putting air in the D-Max tyre, and the bloody valve popped off straight out of the actual brass, but come out of the rubber case. So I've put it back in and I've used some band-aids to put it back on again. So hopefully the band-aid will fix it, and we'll buy around the Smitty's and he should have some glue, maybe some 2-pack aerodite. We can put that in there, tape it up, and then hopefully it'll be good to go. It's the little things in life. This is the Aaron and Smiddy show. They just got swamped by a wave. There's the Kentucky, the end of the Kentucky floating around. I'm not too sure what's going on, but the lads have all gone down to help. I think they've lost the Kentucky and the boat's full of water. Oh yeah, it is. Oh, Granddad's, is it? Granddad's gas tank.
No, it came with my boat.
Oh. Well, this is actually Smitty's stag party. I wasn't going to make a video. I wasn't going to be on the job and point the camera in everyone's face, but I might make a quick one. Well, all of us, 2 days, beer, whiskey, rum, fishing rods and stuff. It's just going to go to Custer, guaranteed. Oh, she started first pop, look at that. We're away. Bloody hell, slow down a bit, bro. Oh, it's working again. The motor stopped, now they got it going. Oh, now it stopped again. Oh, now it's gone. Now they're away. Oh shit, the bed, we got an oversplitter, right? Yeah, put that one out there. Watch your fingers.
Whoa.
Pays to have a knife on hand when working with ropes and stuff under pressure, just in case shit hits a fan, you can cut the rope and save a finger. Blum a neck.
Won't we?
Pretty important for elephant fish or rig or any kind of shark is to trunk them straight away.
cut those fins out because that's where the ammonia taste comes from. A lot of people have eaten it before and say, it tastes like shit. But if you cut the fins out right away, then it's pretty good chewing. I don't like it. I reckon you can't get rid of that ammonia taste in elephant fish, but lots of people love it.
I don't know, it looked pretty cool.
Oh, there it is.
It's dolphin.
Yeah, it's dolphin. Yeah. Runs
and goes for it. You killed it too early.
Here we go. We've got a big one coming.
Come on.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, here we go. He's all right. There's nothing wrong with that. No, we're going to go, but.
Fire. You got to watch out for that stuff, eh, bro? Tony just got a free shave there. Oh, we got an elephant fish. Oh, it's a big one. Elephant fish trunking 101.
It's coming around behind the fin and nice sharp knife usually helps. Down to the bottom, just above the fins.
Yep.
Along the belly.
Yep.
Come out at the bum hole. Straight level off the back fins.
And these little eggs are actually really good eating too. You just pop them in the fry pan.
Okay.
It's a bit of sand there, but
chew it up, tell us what it tastes like. I take that back. It's not actually a delicacy, sorry. Might have put you wrong there. A delicacy.
Different set, eh? Couldn't bring all the hooks in, did we?
There you go, this is how you sharpen your knife. You don't have a steel, folks, you use the top of the window. Started raining, so we're out of here. Couple alleys, one head. Home, James.
Oh. Shit, that ocean's money, isn't it?
Yeah, I know.
The bugger was
coming fast.
It was coming clean, too.
Bit light on the lettuce there, Mr. McDonald's. Oh, yeah, fair call. We ordered 16 of the bastards, but still, you'd think he'd put a little bit of love in there.
Scored some super glue and some electrician's tape, so hopefully this will do it.
Ready?
Yep.
Bit of smoked marlin, courtesy of Troy Dando. Cheers, Troy.
Aha, sorry, sa musím na začiatok zaspäť. Haha, rozmýšľam, jak začať. Aha, toto je niečo úplne inak, haha. Vieš čo následuje, neboj, nesklamem. Toto je náprach legendárny Benjamin. Čakáš nejakú zmenu, marne ne.
What happened, bro?
Well, I was an amateur and went for a crap without my gun. Walked about 100 metres that way and there's a hind there looking at me. Crashed off.
When you go for shit in the woods and it's getting late afternoon, take the shooter.
What do you do if he misses the deer? Do you tell him to shoot it again?
No, do it awesome like miss. You did it before.
Can't remember what I
mean,
I
if he shoots the deer.
Bloody hell, I was going to get him to check his gun because he went real quick and checked the hole and then put it back in. It looked awesome. And I said, could you do that again? And he shook his head at me and now he can't do it. Well, do it.
You want me to do it again?
Yeah.
Went like this.
The wind's blowing upstream, there's a bunch of clearings just over the other side there. But we're going to leave those for the morning, and these other boys are taking the raft across. They're going to go downstream, hunting the big clearings down there, and we're going to go across where Smiddy just saw the deer when he was taking a crap. Bugger, we just spooked one, just took off running. Four blokes walking through the forest, pretty hard to be quiet. Just spooked our second deer, 20 metres away. Right there, damn it. Looking right at us in the trees. I was just saying, I was surprised those guys haven't seen one on the other side of the river, and just, I said, a bumper. Just over there. There's deer sign everywhere. Well, it's too late to shoot now. We actually can't see anything. This camera is just really good at picking up low light. It's way darker than this. We can't actually see across the other side of the river, and the wind's blowing up that way. We've already spooked a couple of deer down here. So I think we're just going to go have a cup of tea and go hunt those clearings in the morning if we can get up. Look at that, it's massive clearings across there. It's got good potential, but it's just too dark to shoot now. Come the lads back. Oh, there they go, off downstream. Four captains in the boat. You saw 10. How many did you shoot?
Just one.
What?
One,
two,
someone's been up here camping. Probably those bloody rafters rafting through, ruining our hunting. Quite a big group too, look at this.
Bit of a bugger. A rather large group was here camping just in the last couple of days. So we heard one bark this morning as we were walking up, didn't even see it, so that deer must be on high alert. It kind of explains why they were really weary last night and didn't come out in the open at all. We're here at this clearing now anyway, so we're going to walk up and see what we can see. Just found a sweet ass side creek, so we're just going to push up here and have a look. There's no fresh prints at all. We'll go for a tuto up here anyway, see what we can see. Most of the deer sign was right where we were camped, and someone was camped upstream here on these clearings. Not these ones, but just over there. One set of yearling prints coming up this side creek. Nice big bowl around there with grass on it. No deer. What can you tell us looking at those prints?
Some type of print of an animal.
I concur.
Yep. It's not here now though.
No, it's not, is it? The boys are all a bit knackered. This is the last day of Smiddy's 3-day stag party. I didn't even get on the piss with these boys. They've all been on the piss, and I've only had a couple of beers and I'm knackered. They must be feeling absolutely shagged. In my neck. I've got to walk all the way back to camp. At least we don't have an animal to carry. Pays to look on the bright side of life, doesn't it? Nice nature stroll back through the long grass. Oh, bloody deer prints here. They were here last night. They just went here this morning. We're about 3k above camp now, so by the time we got here, they'd all walked back into the forest to have a nap. How'd you go, Clem?
Very good. There's some fresh sign up the back of that clearing, but
Nothing. I was quite confident going through there, but maybe a bit too late.
Yeah.
Micro rubbish. It's a no-brainer. Pick up your small bits of rubbish and bloody leave them lying around all over the place. At the very least, if you can't be bothered taking it out, bury it somewhere. Just leave it all lying around. Hey, first world problems. Keep New Zealand green. You know, folks, everywhere I've travelled overseas, well, not everywhere, but most places I've been overseas have a horrendous rubbish problem. Horrendous. There's just rubbish everywhere. Southeast Asia was shocking. It's all the islands and the beaches, 20 meters of rubbish up into the forest, about a meter deep on every single beach. It was shocking. Keep New Zealand green. It's pretty nice being able to cruise around with no rubbish out here. And in the cities too, you know. We've got a pretty good thing going on over here. Doing a good job, eh, bro?
Yeah, always need a couple of supervisors.
We're the supervisors, they're the lackeys. Might have to bloody get them to cook breakfast too. Hopefully it'll be cooked already and the coffee will be on. And see how onto it those other fellas at camp are. Shot.
What is it? Well, bacon these days, isn't it? I could do it.
Was there any dawn chorus this morning?
No. What?
There was no birds this morning, eh? No dawn chorus.
No.
Not a damn thing.
1080.
And we've just seen our first bird, which is a fantail up there. And this area has been 1080 three times in the last 15 years. Go figure. Oh, we're just in Fiordland 10 days ago, never been 1080. Birds everywhere, deer everywhere, heaps of possums.
My place is birds everywhere.
Blimmin' heck. Could one of you greenies out there please explain to me how 1080, why 1080 is a good thing and how it bloody works? It doesn't seem to be working up here. Well, I've just got home. Actually, I got home last night, but I've just got up. I went to bed early because I was knackered. And I walked outside and look what I found. Not Dan, I found that. Was that you, Dan?
No, it's pretty nasty.
It is, it's a human poo, isn't it?
Jesus, someone doesn't like you.
Kristen said the puppy's done a poo right outside the front porch, but I'm pretty sure that is a human poo. Mark Brown. Tell Charlie to bring Mark Brown out for me.
Yeah.
Do you reckon that there was Mark Brown or was that you? Mark Brown or was it you, mate?
It wasn't me.
It wasn't you?
Remember, it was pink.
Was that you, Mark Brown? Mark Brown does look kind of guilty. Hey? Wow. I guess it doesn't matter who it was. I'm going to have to clean it up. Hey. Welcome to the West Coast. It's raining again. Oh yes, just went down to the river to look to see if it was high enough to go low enough to go rafting. And it's high, but it's low enough to go rafting. And it's still raining out here. Oh.
That's the recycling bins. Hopefully they don't try to recycle it back into a children's book. Which they won't, because you know why? Because here on the West Coast, all the recycling goes into the rubbish pit with all the rest of the rubbish. It doesn't even get recycled. How shocking is that? Stag skin. Chuck it on.
I want to tie these bits together.
Yeah, make a jacket out of it. Oh, Sunny's on it now. Look, is that your skin?
Just about to go to work actually, safety kayaking on a raft trip, and the neighbour rang up and said, oh, your car's in the ditch. I said, what? She said, yeah, your wife's car's in the ditch. But luckily, Simon Fowler and the team from Wild Places and Wild Game are here to pull us out of the shit again.
Hey, bloody hell.
We sorted out, you get rafting, bro.
We didn't even have to call him, he was just here. Fortunately, because there's the car in the ditch. And look who else turned up, it's the A-team. Bloody hell. What are the chances? Because I've got to go to work right now, I can't deal with it, but it looks like they're here to... Yeah. Oh, you may remember them from such videos as pull me out of a ditch, actually it's stuck in the mud up at Motueka one time, or Rewaka, when I was up there for the Rewaka hunting camp. Yeah, look, she's well and truly in there. Hey, Kristen. It appears you actually got out of the car with the engine running and just left it in drive with the engine running. Yeah. Is it still in drive with the ignition on?
Really?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. How embarrassing, eh? Blimmin' heck. She must have been in a rush. Anyway, we're going to go rafting now. We'll see you later.
I don't think it's been. It's fine. Grass, that's it.
Oh my god, I'm so lucky.
Here we go down the river. Oh, the river's actually way over there, but we're here, we're close to the river. Bit of liquid sunshine on the coast today. Just run into these fellas here, they'd seen my video on gold mining, so they figured this must be where the gold is. So they've come to poach my spots. I put them onto my secret spot, so they've agreed to give me 10%, they haven't agreed to give me 10% yet, but I know what they're driving, so I can just hold them to ransom. Wait, 10%. Bloody hell. Anyway, time for a cup of tea. That was pretty funny. Me and Dan were ready to go, so we jumped in the van. We're like, all right, let's go. And the girls are still getting changed in the back. Are you decent yet, ladies?
It's great.
Oh, they're still getting changed. I thought you were finished. Now she's completely naked. Before, she just had a bra on and no knickers. I didn't even realise I just jumped in and went, all right, let's go. And then I heard all this laughing and carrying on from the back seat. It's all right, we're just eyes to the front. I've put the mirror up there, so it's all good.
Perks of the job, eh? Perks of the job.
That was good enough.
Anyway, I'm going to leave you with that. Home for a nice cup of tea.
Okay, I've got that one.
You good to go now?
Yes.
Oh, there we go. That's what she looks like with the knickers on. Hey!